As a parent, the moment that you think you've seen it all, something is bound to happen. Well, last week my kids showed me something I had never seen before. My 5-year-old Ariel and my 8-year-old Emery had been playing together upstairs, nice and quietly, which should have been suspicious for us. Then Ariel comes down with something written on her arm. Upon closer inspection, we find out that what was written on her arm was 10 plus 10 equals 20. Here's the thing. When you find something like that on your daughter, the next question that comes to your mind is there anything else written on your body? And as we suspected, there was. Another math problem on her other arm, as well as one on each of her legs. What I've realized is that situations like this cause parents mixed emotions. Because on one hand, I was upset with my daughters for writing on each other, but on the other hand, I was proud that at least they got the answers correct. As much trouble as I have predicting what my kids are going to do or say next, I think people around Jesus had trouble predicting his next moves as well. There's a story in John chapter 8 where Jesus is confronted with a difficult decision. You see, the religious leaders had caught this woman in the act of adultery and brought her before Jesus. Then they asked what Jesus thought that they should do with her. Jesus then bent down and began writing on the ground with his finger. Now, I don't know what he wrote, but I'm guessing it wasn't 10 plus 10 equals 20. After writing for a little bit, he stood back up and said, "Let any one of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." Again, he stooped down and wrote on the ground. At this, those who heard began to go away one at a time, the older ones first, until only Jesus was left. With the woman still standing there, Jesus straightened up and asked her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she said. "Then neither do I condemn you." Jesus declared, "Go now and leave your life of sin." Jesus didn't condemn the woman, but he did encourage her to change. I believe that this example that Jesus gives is truly at the heart of God. Because God wants us to know that no matter what mistakes that we have made in our lives, no matter what sins we have fallen into, no matter how others may label us, that if we choose to repent, God still loves us, and no matter what, we can be forgiven.